Welcome to this online Elim gathering. As we are in the period of Lent, I would like to focus on that wonderful aspect of this season, springtime. The word Lent is a shortened form of the old English word lengthen, meaning spring season. We know that Lent is a season of prayer, penance, and almsgiving. It is a period of reflection and preparation before Easter. And because of these, it is a time to grow, to blossom, and to bear fruit. Imagine spring. Flowers are in bloom in their most vivid colors. The plants are in their most illustrious green. And fruits and vegetables are ripe and ready for picking. I can imagine the yellow mangoes. Ang sarap. I encourage you to desire this kind of growth for your spiritual lives this Lent. Let it be your spiritual springtime. Let this season be your time to blossom and shine in the Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hello, brothers and sisters, and welcome to our online Elim gathering. Let us now come together in worship to proclaim the majesty of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Yeah.
Father, you are truly matchless. Send us your Spirit as we listen to your word. In Jesus' name, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. And now let us welcome teacher of the word, full-time servant of the Lord, Brother Mars Catan.
Brothers and sisters, we are now right in the middle of the celebration of Lent. But how do we celebrate Lent? Sina-celebrate nga ba yun? Masaya ba yun? Malungkot? Ano nga ba ang Lent? We might have an idea, but today, let us delve a little bit deeper so that ma-maximize ang ating appreciation, and hopefully, ito ang isa sa mga pinaka-meaningful, makabuluhan na celebrations of Lent. The word Lent is taken from Latin, quadragesima. Sa ating mga Pilipino, napakadali kasi alam natin ang salitang Quaresma. And it means 40, 4-0. Lent is a period of 40 days from Ash Wednesday until Easter. Ngayon, sa mga mahilig sa mathematics katulad ko, 7 weeks yan. Eksakto, 7 weeks, 40 days. O sige, tingnan natin. Ha? 7 weeks times how many days in a week? 7. Ilan yon? 49. Nako, sobra. Alam nyo, pag sa simbahan, hindi binibilang as a feast day or any special day ang Sunday. Why? Because Sunday is specifically reserved for Jesus Christ. Ang feast day lang na pwede sa Sunday, for Jesus Christ. Katulad ng Santo Niño, Nazareno, Jesus Christ lahat yan. Pero pansinin niyo, kahit ibang santo, kahit nga si Mama Mary, iurong yan ng Lunes. So, Sundays are specifically reserved days for the church. So, tanggalin na natin ang Sunday. So, that means 6 days na lang. So, 7 weeks times 6 days, ilan? 42. Sobra pa rin. Nag-umpisa tayo sa Ash Wednesday. So, tanggalin na natin ang Monday at Tuesday. So, 42 minus 2, 40. Ayan ang ating Quaresma. So, at least sa umpisa pa lang, maliwanag sa atin, paano naging 40 days from Ash Wednesday until Easter. Now, 40 is a special biblical number. Moses, alam natin, spent 40 years in the desert, and he led the Israelites on their journey for 40 years. And alam nyo ba, when he got the Ten Commandments from Mount Sinai, he was, syempre, madaling hulaan, clue na nga eh, he was on Mount Sinai with God for 40 days. Alam natin ang the Great Flood, di ba? It rained for 40 days and nights during the time of Noah. Elijah spent 40 days and nights on Mount Horeb. Jonah the prophet proclaimed to Nineveh, magsisi na kayo, kung hindi, mawawasak ang bayan ninyo. And he gave them what? 40 days. Nagsisi nga ang Nineveh. 40 days also for us represents the time that Jesus spent in the desert before he began his public ministry, during which time he was tempted by the devil. So, ito ay preparation. Preparation for what? Something really, really great. Jesus, after the 40 days in the desert, went on his public ministry. Ibig sabihin, proclamation of the goodness of God to the world. And for Christian faith, tayo, the resurrection, Easter Sunday, is the most special day. It is at the very core of our faith. Kaya tayo may Christianity because of the resurrection. So, itong 40 days, itong season of Lent, is really, really very special for us. Now, what do we do during this time? Aside from taking the word Lent from Latin, quadragesima, meron ding Old English, Lenten, or German, Lenz, or Lenzo, na kung ibig sabihin ay spring season, springtime. Baka lang sa Pilipinas, hindi natin masyadong naintindihan kasi sa atin, tag-init lang at tag-ulan. Pero, yung mga ibang bahagi ng mundo na merong winter, spring, summer, or fall, yan, kompleto sila. Spring comes after winter. Winter frozen lahat. No? Ang mga halaman ay akala mo patay. Pero talagang ano, frozen in time, yan. Lahat, mga hayop natutulog, hibernating sa ilalim ng lupa. Kahit mga isda, hindi nyo nakikita kasi yung ibabaw ng lake, ng rivers, frozen. Pero pagdating ng springtime, natutunaw yung yelo. Natutunaw, nabubuhay ulit. Nakikita nyo ulit yung mga isda, yung mga halaman, puti, brown, biglang magiging green ulit. Springtime is a time of new life. New life. Kaya nga pag Easter, di ba, may mga itlog, Easter bunny, it just represents springtime, new life, bagong buhay. And so we need to prepare because Lent prepares us for a new life that is to come. Now, how do we prepare? Ang preparation ba parang basta tulog ka lang, tapos walang mangyayari, tapos basta new life? Hindi. There's some things that we can do to prepare. Now, many of us are already familiar with the three pillars of Lent. Prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. Alam ko, alam na ninyong lahat yan. Nakakailang homily na tayo yan at alam natin yan. But you know, I'd like to share with you an added dimension to this. Because the season of Lent is not only for our personal enrichment as a child of God. You know, the whole spirit behind Lent boils down to the greatest commandment. Ano ba yung greatest commandment? Love God with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength. Love our neighbor as ourselves. Yan ang pinaka talaga. So, kung naging mataimtim tayo, we grew in our devotions, pero hindi naman nadagdagan yung love for God and love for neighbor, wala rin, di ba? So, dapat yung ating dimension of prayer, fasting, and almsgiving has a community dimension, has a dimension for others, has a dimension for God. Halimbawa, prayer. Don't just spend time in prayer. Siyempre, sabi ni Lord, ask and you will receive. Yes, we ask. Lord, lahat ng mga pangangailangan ko, lalo na ngayon, gipit talaga, maraming bahagi sa mundo, kahit nga dito sa Pilipinas. Right now, I am sharing this word of God. No? We're taking time to do this because temporarily tinigil ang ating ilim gatherings, public masses, dahil sa spread ng virus. But you know, prayer, more people have come to prayer. But don't just pray for ourselves. Pray for others. No? Pray for your loved ones. Pray for your enemies. May kinaiinisan ka? Pray for those people. Pray for our country. Pray for the poor. Pray for the sick. Now is a special time. I know many people are praying for all health workers. Pray for them. And that is really how we can move forward in this devotion of prayer. Next, fasting. So, alam naman natin ang fasting, hindi kakain. So, ibang-ibang uri yan. Merong nagsiskip ng meal, merong buong araw hindi kumakain, meron din tayong abstinence. Pero, how can we do that so that it manifests our love for God and our love for others? Here's some example or maybe sharing a tip. The time na hindi ka kumain, usually ano, kumakain tayo 20 minutes, 30 minutes, use that. Spend in praying for others. The money na hindi mo ginastos kasi hindi mo kinain, magkanong pagkain mo, 100 pesos, 200 pesos, 50 pesos, kahit ano pa yan, ibigay natin sa mahihirap. Share. Or buy food and share the food with others. Pwede rin. In other words, yung ating fasting, yes, we will grow in our devotion. And maybe, feel natin ang namalapit si Lord sa atin. Pero dapat, meron siyang dimension also for others. Ano pa? Almsgiving. Yes, meron tayong personal almsgiving. No? 20 pesos, 50, 100. And for sure, that will help somebody, whether you give it to the church or to somebody else directly. But the church now, especially the church in the Philippines, is exhorting, is recommending and encouraging everyone for more purposeful and collective giving so that more people can be helped. Halimbawa, yung pondo ng Pinoy, alam nyo naman kung paano nag-umpisa yan. Binchi-binchi ko lang yan. Pero ngayon, may mga scholars, marami nang natutulungan, lumaki na siya. But there are communities also who are involved in giving. Tayo sa Ilim, meron din tayong charity fund. pwede tayong magbigay dyan. And imbis na yung 20 pesos, 100 piso, nakabuo tayo ng 10,000, 20,000, malaking tulong yan sa mga communities that we are reaching out to. So here we are, the three pillars of Lent: prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. Transform it. Make it help not just ourselves grow closer with God, but for others. Ngayon, ang panghuli, in terms of how we can make this Lent really meaningful and special, it is this: be transformed ourselves by replacing our vices with virtues. Again, replace our vices with virtues. Paano? Alam nyo ang bisyo, kaya bisyo ang tinawag, because it is something that you keep on doing. Sa madaling salita, it is a bad habit. So, just think, ano-ano mga bad habits natin? Mamili ka lang ng isa. Yan. Can we do away with that bad habit? Mawawalan ka ng bisyo. Pero, imbis na nawala lang yon, halimbawa, frequent cravings for something, no? That can be a vice. Foul language, sarcasm, yung bang nega ka na lang ng nega, ang dami nang problema, negative pa rin tayo. Nakuuso ngayon kasi maraming naka-quarantine, stay at home, mga binges, all sort of binges, no? Games, movies, food, kung ano-ano, no? Kung mga paisa-isang ganon, I wouldn't say na masama yun. Pero alam nyo yon, yung kung tuloy-tuloy, hinahanap-hanap ng katawan natin, ng kaisipan natin, then it becomes a vice. Try to do away with that. That might help. And hindi lang do away, but replace it with something. Replace it with a good habit, virtue. I'm sure you do something good. All of us are able to do something good. Pero let's not just do it once. Kasi good thing lang yun, di ba? We want it to become a virtue. Pero how do we make a good thing become a virtue? By transforming it to becoming a good habit. Yung bang nakasanayan mo na, no? So kung may effort sa umpisa, okay lang yan. But remember, if you do something often enough, it will become a part of you and you will change. When you're able to add a virtue, that means character has been built up. Your character, my character. Example, gratitude, may do it more frequently. Or smiling to someone else, di ka palangiti, ngumiti ka. Don't get upset with little things, katulad ng walang barya, mahaba ang pila, kulang ang pagkain, mainit o masyadong malamig, ganyan. Transform it. Learn to compliment one another. In these trying times, brothers and sisters, hope is our mark. Hope is the mark of Christianity. Bring somebody that hope. I pray, brothers and sisters, that this may be one of the most meaningful periods of Lent for us. Let us remember the core value of Lent: loving God with our whole mind, heart, soul, and strength, loving others as we love ourselves. At dinugtungan pa ni Jesus yan: love others as I have loved you. Nako, yun ang mabigat, di ba? If we love others as we love ourselves, 50-50 hati tayo. But if we love others as Jesus loved us, nako, He gave His life for us. I'm sure you know what God is telling us to do, especially during these trying times. Let us help one another. Let us help others during this time. Be more faithful to our devotions to the Lord. And turn out to be better Christians than before this season of Lent started. God bless you.
Thank you, Brother Morris, for this teaching about Lent. Elim Community's vision is to spread the good news to the ends of the earth. If you want to be part of this work of evangelization, please give your tithes, love offerings, and donations to Prayer to Our Lady of Elim. O dear Mary, Lady of Elim, sweet and pure, pray that your Son Jesus will, to innocence and holiness restore, the hearts and minds of long-lost souls. Pray that the seed of glad tidings, sown in our hearts, will stir us to great hope, faith, and love. Pray for the vision and intentions of community and of the Church, that with the Lord's watchful care and generous provisions, they shall all be. Pray that a polluted world and all institutions will, from a powerful outpouring of the latter rain, experience the blessings of fresh living water, a renewal of the spirit and healing of our land and of all nations. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Elim Missions Prayer. Lord, I make myself available for the ministry of missionary evangelization. On my knees or in the mission field, within our borders or on foreign soil, for a single soul or for the multitudes. Empower me for abundant soul winning. By your Spirit, make me an instrument of your love and mercy, a witness bold and unashamed, and an inspiring bearer of the good news. Send us the laborers, technology, and resources to reach the world. Help us break barriers, overcome obstacles, and penetrate new territories that all the peoples of the earth may know that you are God and there is no other. And to all those we reach, Lord, raise them up to become your true disciples. Here I am, Lord. Send me in Jesus' name. Amen. Oracio Imperata. God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 virus that has claimed lives and has affected many. We pray for your grace, for the people tasked with studying the nature and cause of this virus and its disease, and of stemming the tide of its transmission. Guide the hands and minds of medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion, and of those governments and private agencies that must find cure and solution to this epidemic. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Grant us the grace to work for the good of all and to help those in need. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Mary, help of all Christians, pray for us. Saint Raphael, the Archangel, pray for us. Saint Roch, pray for us. Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. Saint Pedro Calungsod, pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord God, we thank you for your example of love, of how you have loved us, that you gave your life for us, that we commemorate this every year through Lent, through your passion, the cross, knowing, O Lord God, that the fruit of all of this is your love for us and your saving and redeeming grace, taking upon yourself our sins. We are sorry, O Lord God, for the sins that we have committed to ourselves, to God, to others. We pray, O Lord God, for your mercy upon us. We pray that you look upon us, O Lord God, with your grace, remove, wash away our sins, and allow us to be freed from all of this guilt, O Lord God. We pray that you transform us during this season of Lent. We pray, Lord God, that you make us more and more like Jesus. And this is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Solitary life instead, thinking only of ourselves. Though one day he had to show the way. Now the past doesn't rain. We wander through the desert, seeking for a total rest. We have found a place of happiness where we all could be refreshed. Now the past doesn't really matter, for we all have found a home. With one mind and one heart, where Jesus is our yeah.